Brothers and sisters, we are going to prepare, many of us preparing themselves to go to Makkah to perform the Hajj, Manasik al-Hajj. And that's why this is the month of preparation. These are called months of Hajj. Although we know practically you can finish Hajj within a week or maximum 10 days, done. But Allah, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the shuhur, the months of Hajj? Months of Hajj. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الحج أشهر معلومات. Hajj is during well-known months. Months. Well, it is in one month, main one. All these months before, starting from Shawwal, Dhul Qa'dah, and the first, almost first half of Dhul Hijjah, is a month of Hajj. Because we need huge preparation. Huge preparation. Preparation of learning how to perform it, which is very fard as well. Not only to do the Hajj is fard, to learn is how to perform the Hajj, it is also fard. I know many of us are not very interested of learning our knowledge of deen. We learn basic knowledge we are very happy with. And any time, any opportunity to learning more, as if we consider it is nafal. But when you go for fard Hajj, ما لا يتم الواجب إلا به فهو واجب is anything which is compulsory to perform whatever necessary to perform that is also necessary, that is also farad, that is also obligatory. If you don't know how to perform the Hajj, you gone for Hajj, you miss the farad one. You're learning knowledge of Hajj, masail, adab, all the right ways, methodology is also farad. As Imam Bukhari also said, before doing any action, any ibadah, speaking anything, saying anything, how to say, how to perform, this is also fard. And so we'll be learning, attending many of the Hajj training sessions. As you know, we'll be having organizing Hajj training session tomorrow and Sunday, Saturday, Sunday, Asr to Isha is the Bangla Hajj Talim, and week after Saturday is our English Hajj Talim after Zuhur. So attending Hajj Talim session, Hajj training session is very important to learn fiqh al-Hajj, how to perform. Also not only attending one circle, one session, to read books of the manasik, to read it, how to perform Hajj and Umrah. Also to see many kind of CDs and watching whatever is in the internet, a nice kind of presentation available. That we need to utilize our time. And also, during these months, learning, reading, and preparing ourselves, psychologically, mentally, prepare, you know, financially, in all way. And most important one to take with us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Hajj Jani, أَتَزَوَّدُوا, take your provision when coming to Hajj. Take provisions, take provisions. Then he said, فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. And indeed, the best of the provisions is taqwa. To carry taqwa. What is taqwa? To obey what Allah has commanded. And to abstain from what Allah has made forbidden for us. Abstain from all kind of sins is needed. Because we need to go to the place, which is a sacred place, a holy sites, al-masha'ir al-muqaddasa. We need to respect, honor that area itself. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given us order to prepare for Hajj from now on, all these 3 months, Shawwal, Dhul Qa'dah, even Dhul Hajjah, he said, Al-Hajju Ashuru Ma'lumat, Hajj is during well-known months, فَمَنْ فَرَضَ فِيهِنَّ الْحَجَّ فَلَا رَفَثَ وَلَا فُسُوقَ وَلَا جِدَالَ فِي الْحَجِّ. So whoever made Hajj obligatory upon himself, therein in the time of, in the state of Ihram, no sexual relations and no disobedience and no disputing during Hajj. So you are prepared spiritually. You are away from all kinds of sins. And that's why you need taqwa. وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. And in the holy site in Mecca, Allah has given us warning. وَمَنْ يُرِدْ فِيهِ بِإِلْحَادٍ بِالظُّلْمِ نُذِقْهُ مِنْ عَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. And whoever intends a deed therein of deviation, by wrongdoing, We will make him taste of a painful punishment. So, we have to perform the Hajj without committing sin. And that is the command from Allah that the ta'zim, honoring these places. وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ حُرُمَاتِ اللَّهِ فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ. And whoever honors the sacred things of Allah, sacred symbols of Allah, sacred sites of Allah, it is best for him in the sight of his Lord. So Allah will, it will be very good to Allah, with Allah, that he has respected, he has honored these holy sites by not committing any sin. وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. And whoever honors the symbols, i.e. the rites and the sites and the symbols of Allah, indeed, it is from the piety of the heart. And this is the taqwa, in fact, what we are looking for. So to committing, thus intending, planning, or some kind of plan came in the mind to commit a sin there, that intention itself could be a sin. The tafsir of this ayah, the imams said, Imam Ibn or Umar ibn Khattab or Ibn Kathir rahmatullah alayhi said that قال بعض أهل العلم من هم أن يعمل سيئة بمكة أذاقه الله العذاب الأليم بسبب همه بذلك. In this ayah, okay, which is Surah Hajj 25 number ayah, Imam Ibn Kathir said, many of the scholars said, whoever only made the intention to commit a sin in Mecca, Allah will taste him the severe punishment, make him tasting severe punishment. That itself will be considered as a sin. وَإِنْ لَمْ يَفْعَلْهَا بِخِلَافِ غَيْرِ الْحَرَمِ الْمَكِّ مِنَ الْبِقَاءِ فَلَا يُعَاقَبُ فِيهِ بِالْهَمْ. While committing or making an intention of sin anywhere else other than Mecca, you thought you'd be committing this sin, but you did not commit it, Allah will forgive you. Any other place. But in Mecca, even having this intention is a sin. Another hadith came from Abdul ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. لو أن رجلا هم فيه بإلحاد أهو بعدن أهو بعدن أبيا قرية على جانب البحر ناحية اليمن لا أذاقه الله عز وجل عذابا أليما. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu narrates as well that anyone did commit some kind of transgression, some kind of committing sin, some kind of disobedience of Allah in Mecca, even though he is in Adan, which is in Yemen, okay, while he's coming to Hajj, he may be punished by Allah. So from now on, we have to be ready that we are going to that sacred place, how much we are ready for that blessed journey. Are we enough prepare ourselves? Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu warned us about Mecca, al-Balad al-Amin, this blessed and secure, the city of security. He said to the people, time of Hajj, Ya Ahla Mecca, Allah, Allah fi haramillah. O people of Mecca, I warn you about the sanctity of Allah, the holy city of Mecca, to keep its honor and respect. Then he said, La an ukhtiya sab'ina khatiya bi rukba wa hiya wadi al-ma'ruf qurba al-ta'if ahabbu ilayya min an ukhtiya khatiyatan wahidatan fil haram. He said, if I commit 70 sins I commit in other place like Rukba, a place in Taif, is much better than committing one sin in Mecca. Comparing 70 sins is easier, lighter than committing one sin in Mecca. That's why many of the Sahaba are respecting so much. Be careful, always aware, am I committing any sin in Mecca? Abdul ibn Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu, a Sahabi, he, when he will come for Mecca to perform Hajj and Umrah, he will have two tents. At that time, there are no hotels, five-star, all these star hotels in Mecca, time of Sahaba. They used to bring with them the tents to sleep. So he will be bringing two tents, one tent outside Haram area, other one inside Haram, for the ibadah, take rest. He will be having in the haram, and another tent is for sleeping with his wife or other, you know, time, spending time. He will have another tent outside haram, out of respect. التابعي الجليل سعيد بن المسيب رضي الله عنه says, بلغني أن أهل مكة أو قال ساكن مكة لن يهلكوا حتى يكون الحل والحرم عندهم بمنزلة الحل. There is a report came to him that Ahl Makkah, or the people of Makkah, or the residents of Makkah, whoever is staying in Makkah, will be not punished until they consider hell and haram is same. That means Makkah and outside cities, Makkah or place of Makkah is same to them. They are not careful about Makkah. If they consider committing sin here and outside is same, this is their attitude, they may be punished. This is, brothers and sisters, you are planning to go for Hajj. Even though you're not going this year, you're going next year. You are not going for Hajj, you'll be going for Umrah very soon. That we need to learn, adab of this sacred place, adab of this, all this. And that's why it is al-baladul haram. In hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِنَّ هَذَا الْبَلَدَ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَهُوَ حَرَامٌ بِحُرْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ وإنه لم يحل القتال فيه لأحد قبلي ولم يحل لي إلا ساعة من نهار فهو حرام بحرمة الله إلى يوم القيامة لا يعضد شوكه ولا ينفر صيده ولا يلتقط لقطته إلا من عرفها ولا يختل خلاها. Okay, the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no doubt Allah has made this place Mecca a sanctuary since the creation of the heavens and the earth, and will remain a sanctuary till the day of resurrection as Allah has ordained its sanctity. Fighting was not permissible in it for anyone before me, and even for me, it was allowed only for a portion of a day. So it is a sanctuary with Allah's sanctity till the day of resurrection. Its thorns should not be uprooted, and its fallen things should not be picked up except by one who would announce that publicly, and its vegetation, grasses, etc., should not be cut. All this, the respect and honor to these holy sites, we need to take in our mind always that where we are in that holy site, how careful we are. This is this whole city, and this house of Allah is so special that this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared as the Qibla of the Muslims, wherever we are. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq that we are prepared mentally, knowledge-wise, by knowing all masail of Hajj and reading history. Before going to Hajj, read history of who built this house. Ibrahim alayhi salam. How? To his son, two men. There's no any other builder and laborers ever available. How hard was the deed? What is the story of Zamzam? Subhanallah. That great contribution of our mother Hadir alayhi salatu wasalam, with her son alone living there. And she is running for water for her child between Safa and Marwa. When you run, remember that. We just do it, we don't remember. We are heedless. And that is khushu in the Hajj. Like khushu in the Salah is ruh. That we need to, all the symbol, all the historic information, the status of the place we are in. When you are doing tawaf, remember, this is the place. Many times our Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam was doing tawaf. Maybe my step is falling on his footstep. That feeling, emotion we need. Just not only just doing the ritual and we're absent mind. This is Hajj. This we need to keep in our mind. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا واتوبوا إليه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.